Hello, this is Tobias, and today I will play Open Transport Tycoon Deluxe, OpenTTD. Now, this is obviously a tycoon game, an open source tycoon game. So, you can see all the trains running, cars, planes. I used to play a lot of Railroad Tycoon, the original. This one came out somewhat later. It has less industry management and stuff like this, and much more fun gameplay. So I stopped playing before I got on the internet, so I totally forgot about it. But a month back or so, I noticed that Portage, my package management system, has OpenTTD, Open Transport Tycoon. And so I checked it out, looked at the website, and it looks like there was a very active community of players who made more and more patches for this game, and eventually they wrote an open source version. In the beginning it only worked with the original art assets, like this Ultima clone or the Panzer General clone do. But now there are open graphics, open sounds, open music, even two types of open music. And you can play. Now it's a totally GPL game, or Creative Commons game. Now it has a lot of options. These are the basic options from the old game. These are the settings from the patch and stuff like this. This, I think those were hidden features in around half of those, and the other hidden features in the TTD patch, that is the modded version, and the other half are new in the open source version. So interesting ones if you want to play yourself and have never played before are tooltips. Yeah, tooltips are important. I think they are quite slow in this game. You can also put them to right click for tooltip, default railway, timetables, complicated stuff, construction, signals. Oh, this is important. The most important change from the patch version to the open source version. Dragging signals, can use it in-game stuff. Building on slopes, also nice. Also new in the open source version. Maximum links. Airports never expire. Nice. Trees, vehicles. Ah, the new pathfinding algorithm, the old pathfinder sucked. The new one is great. So reportedly for ships it gets to hog a lot of resources, but I don't use ships much. Auto renew, maintenance. There are one or two very important features. I'm playing with realistic acceleration. I think it's the default these days. You can make your trains longer, very long. Car speed limits. I will use new graphics speed limits. Wide multiplayer means freight trains are heavier than they are in the normal game. 4 times heavier for me. This one is important. New income. Number of plane crashes. Oh yes, number of train crashes. Where is it? Well, when I find it. Where was it? No, it's in difficulty options, now I remembered. Yes, that's also important. This is the most important setting. Vehicles never expire, always put it to on. Otherwise you will use your vehicles very fast. Road acceleration is new in this version. I'm playing, you can see it because I don't have the things, the window decorations in my recording window. I'm playing the live version. So, station spread, cargo handling, new cargo algorithm. Like I said, there's lots and lots of changes from the old version that I played as a child in this new and improved version. Inflation, feeders, computers. So, if you download the game, a lot of stuff won't work out of the box. You have to use the online content to get the expansions for the game. For example, the open source graphics, they might or might not come with your install, depending on what system you're on. The extra music, the sounds, maps of Europe and other countries. Then the expansion packs with more and better trains, or airplanes, or for example different looking tunnels. I will play with a few of those on. Scenarios and AIs. You need to download AIs to use them. The AI in the original game was very, very bad. These new ones are quite good, but the usual playstyle that I use and from what I've seen, what most other people play who don't play multiplayer, they play with the AI off. And a lot of those AIs, for example, are made to build a nice looking network, or only services towns, so the towns grow and don't get in the way, or there are others like this one, which is only written for a challenge, for the AI challenge. Sort of thing is very interesting. New graph setting, adventure setting, difficulty settings, AI settings. Here you can choose the AIs. I will use street traffic, which puts random civilian cars on the town streets of big towns. This one builds a highway network to airplane guys, because this way I can show off airplanes without having to build them myself. Then two which use roads, so I can show up how I used to play with the AI on my when I was a child. So difficulty settings, maximum number of competitors, number of towns low. I prefer to do industry trains, so those are low. Number of industries normal, this is more than enough. Maximum loan on maximum, this makes the game start faster. Interest rate, not really important. Vehicle running cost, also not that important. Construction speed of competitors, also AI difficulty. Vehicles breakdown, reduced. There are much too many in the game, even just reduced. Subsidies, you get subsidies, but they are not important. Cost of construction, terrain type. This of course changes the way you construct stuff. But this also influences world generation. There's also world generation fluctuating or steady fluctuating causes. Sometimes they are the opposite of booms, base, I think it's called. Well, economic downturn, where no new industries are built and industries don't grow and stuff like this. And sometimes industries go broke, quit. Train reversing, where trains can make turns. Disasters off, they are very annoying, because if you play with smooth economy, the disaster icon is not shown. I will show off the most interesting disaster from my save game. Oh yes, I had planned to do this. City Council's attitude towards area reconstructuring. Yes, how much you can build in your city, this is on easiest. So, new game, you can give your map size, starting date. 1950 is a standard for the normal game. If you use new graphs, you probably want to start somewhere earlier, because of the dates of the vehicles. This is realistic date, where the Europe got the new electric trains were starting to show up in Europe. with the standard games you get electric trains in 65. So here again, train generation, but I forgot to show this one, new crafts. This is sort of mods. Okay, DB set, those can download it be downloaded here, most of them. The only one I have that is not in there is the DB set, that is a German train set. Then landscaping costs makes changing the landscape more expensive. Generic cars, which looks fine. Station names from industry. This way when I place a station near industry, it gets a better name. Fish for more ships. More cars. Better looking stations. Even more better looking stations. A specific type of train. Different train tracks for different speeds and the very useful planning track. Again, better looking stations. A vacuum tube train, I haven't tried it out yet, but it's an ultra fast train that shows up late in the game. Even more and more expensive short and slow bridges.